Guys, to understand RS nomenclature in flying wedge formula, we'll take an example. Guys, in this flying wedge formula, any group attached to broken wedge will be going behind the plane, below the plane, means away from observer. And any group or atom attached to this solid wedge will be coming towards the observer, above the plane. And these two solid lines will be on the plane. Now let me attach the groups. Let us say H is attached to broken wedge, B are attached to solid wedge. And here you can see this is CH3, this is CH2, this is CH3. First of all, find whether the carbon is chiral or not. So this carbon is connected to hydrogen, Br, CH3 and C2H5. Since four different groups or atoms are attached, that is why this carbon is chiral carbon. Now to find RS configuration, we have to assign priorities to these groups. We all know priorities are given on the basis of atomic number of the atom directly connected to chiral carbon. Here you can see Br is connected, here carbon, here carbon, here hydrogen. So of course Br will be given first priority, and carbon carbon will have higher priority than hydrogen. So here you have to write 2, 3. So hydrogen by default will become fourth priority group. Now how to decide priorities for these two carbon atoms? So this carbon is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms, and this carbon is attached to 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 carbon. That is why higher priority group will be this CH2. So I'll say this as 2, this as 3. So we have assigned priorities to different groups or atoms attached to this chiral carbon. Now for RS configuration, please keep in mind the fourth priority group must be below the plane, going away from the observer. And that is why the fourth priority group must be on broken wedge. And since here it is already on broken wedge, just check 1, 2, 3 movement. So 1, 2, 3 movement here is clockwise, and that is why configuration of this carbon will be R. Now I will take another example where fourth priority group will not be on broken wedge. Guys, now if you see, this carbon is chiral because it is connected to one Cl, one hydrogen, one tertiary butyl group, one ethyl group. So this carbon is attached to 4 different groups. That is why chiral carbon. Now we have to assign priorities. Of course, Cl has highest atomic number. That is why Cl will be given first priority. Now there are 2 carbon atoms and 1 hydrogen. Of course, hydrogen will be of less priority. So I will give this as fourth priority. And between these 2 carbon atoms, here the carbon is connected to 2 hydrogen and 1 carbon. While here, this carbon is connected to carbon, carbon, carbon. You can see methyl, methyl, methyl. That is why this group will get higher priority. So I'll say this as second priority, this as third priority. So we have assigned priorities. Now you can see fourth priority group is not on broken wedge. So we have to bring this fourth priority group on broken wedge by interchange operation. And for that, how many interchanges? Even number of interchanges. Even number of interchanges to avoid any configurational change. So I'll exchange fourth priority and first priority group. At the same time, I'll exchange the second priority and third priority. So you can see, I can write here first priority, broken wedge, fourth priority, and this side I'll write third priority group, this side I'll write second priority group, and then check movement 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3 movement here comes as clockwise. That is why configuration of this carbon is R. Guys, now I'm giving you 3 examples. You check whether you have understood the concept or not.